Alright, so this is a suggestion from Patreon. The name of the song is Killing in the Name by the band Rage Against the Machine. If you are new here, please like and subscribe. The more that you like this content, the more that I know that you specifically would like to see more of this specific type of content. Alright? Let's go ahead and jump into this immediately, alright? That groove is killer. I hear some cowbells. All right. I kind of feel like I need some like long hair so I can headbang to this shit, bro. I feel like I need to. At least one time in my life. Maybe I'll get like a wig or something, bro. I don't know. I'm bald as hell. All right.
Some of those that were forces are the same that burn crosses. Some of those that work forces are the same that burn crosses. Some of those that work forces are the same that burn crosses. Some of those that work forces draw the same that burn crosses.
I mean, basically what he is saying is almost extremely obvious, right? He's saying that the Klan and other like racialized hate groups have infiltrated all types of forces, police forces, military forces, the fire department potentially, right? Like this is what they're saying. He's saying that these entities are not, in a sense, to be trusted because they are failing on their hiring practices. Basically, right? You're allowing somehow you're allowing these entities to get into power, right? And then ward their power, their physical power, over the masses of people who are the opposites of them. Okay? That's basically this.
Now you do what they told you.
That's interesting. This could be a couple of things, right? Now they do what they told you, right? That could either be the entities, right, that used to burn crosses are now the ones in power, and they're telling the mere citizens, right, to do exactly what they're saying when their specific opinion has really no merit, right? But because now they're in authority, you have to, right? So they are, in a sense, perpetuating their own internal hatred. I guess what I mean is that they are making it so you now have to listen to their nonsense, bro, right? Because the most punishable by death crime in America is disrespecting a police officer. Not like literally, the most punishable crime in America is disrespecting a police officer or either generally standing up for your own specific rights. But keep in mind, right? Not every single police officer is what they're depicting, right? So we need to come there. We need to be intellectually honest here and say not every single police officer is like this, bro, right? Because like some of my legitimately best friends here in Spain are police officers, right? I don't know what it is. They're just cool as hell, right? You know, they know about guns. I know about guns, right? So like it's just an interesting scenario, right? So yeah, like dudes, like keep that in mind. It's not the whole, it's not just that. There are good people in a mix of a lot of bad people or there may be a little bit of bad people, but and a lot of good people. But I think there was like a, a thought experiment that came out, bro, right? How can you say a entity is good if the good people within the entity are not specifically weeding out the bad, right? That thin blue line is interesting, right? Keep that in mind. Keep that in mind, right? They don't snitch on each other, so that sounds like a gang, right? Let's get it.
Now you do what they told ya. 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 Now you do what they told ya.
Okay, you justify those who died. Oh, so basically, again, dude, it's like, listen, your life had value, kinda. But as soon as you, in a sense, did anything that the police didn't want, right? Your death will be justified no matter what. Trust me when I say this. Like, if you look at like a lot of the instances of like police killings, right? Specifically. Sorry, I'm still getting over my sickness, yes? If you look at those instances, right, you start to notice that as soon as the person who did not have the weapon died, all of their previous back history all of a sudden means a lot more, right? And all of the commendations and none of the officer complaints are readily available. If you ever notice that, pay close attention to that specific thing. Okay, by wearing a badge, they're the chosen whites. This could be referencing the chosen whites, potentially like the chosen people, potentially, or like the people who were in the eyes of the supremacists. Yes, they were chosen to civilize us mere savages, basically, right? That could be what he's referring to, the concept of Europeans civilizing the savages. All right, let's get it.
Some of those that were forces are the same that brought crosses. Some of those that were forces are the same that brought crosses. Some of those that were forces are the same that brought crosses. Killing in the name of.
Dude, the guitar is crazy, bro.
You do what they told you. Now you do what they told you. Now you do what they.
Maybe like state sanctioned killings potentially also. Now they do what they told you. I'm trying to put like a definition to potentially this specific phrase that he's saying. Now they do what they told you. I keep going back to this. Like they, it could be someone specifically. Like it could be like they're telling you exactly what to do, so you have to do it, right? Or the state is telling you to do one thing. They're trying to tell you to stand up for a overall system that has historically been horrifying to multiple groups of people in America, right? So now you have to, you can go into the to this organization with no disdain or hate within you specifically, potentially. And the people that are around you, because some of them may be the ones who burn crosses, right? They can obviously and easily influence you to target specific groups more so than other groups, right? Like, don't arrest this guy. His father may be a judge. Arrest this guy. Yeah. See what I'm saying? It could be that. Even if you did not go into the organization as a bigoted person, potentially. you can easily come out as one if you are doing exactly what they told you. Maybe that's where he's going with that, right? Potentially. Let's get it.
Told ya. Do what they told ya.
Control. It's building towards something great. Oh, hold on. I want to blatantly say something. This is not always a specific racialized thing, right? So keep this in mind thoroughly when we're talking about this specific thing, because it can also fall into like almost easily a class issue, right? So it's not a specific racialized type of thing, but it seems as if they're mainly going towards the racial route, right? And I don't even like using the word racial because we are one literal race, but like, but that's basically, I'm going to use it for the context of this here. And so that's basically it. So a lot of it has to do with like, your like socioeconomic like status, right? Because like, look at the rates of horrible shit that happens to like impoverished people of European descent, right? That's a thing, bro. That is a literal thing. Okay. So the whole narrative of just what they show on TV, basically, where all you see is like one specific group being targeted by police, right? Okay. Per capita, you know, it's a little crazy. Don't get that confused at all. Look at the marijuana arrest rates between groups of people, but, impoverished or lower class Europeans, or people of European descent suffer from this shit pretty much the same way, right? Or people from like the country, right? Like ATF targets them crazily, bro. All right? So keep that in mind. It's a system thing, right? All right? Let's get it. Okay. I think that's self-explanatory right there. You're raging against the machine right now, bro. I get that. Okay. Yeah, this song is like a listen, I'm gonna say something. I absolutely hate that the word when you add like mother to the word, bro, because like it has like super strange like historical like connotations around it, right? Like it goes back to like I don't know, like it may go back even further, but to my knowledge it came from like a specific like entity, right? I want to say Willie Lynch, actually. He had like slave breeding farms or something, bro. So I don't know if he's using that word specifically on purpose, but the slave breeding farms, basically they would forcefully breed like male slaves with their mothers, right? If the stock was good, perfect height and strength and all these other things, right? Muscular mass and other nonsense, right? They would specifically breed with the mother for the sole purpose of that. And then around it, they would say, hey, go get that little MF, right? You see what I'm saying? It's a little weird to call somebody that, bro. But either way, dudes, that's just my specific knowledge of the word. I don't know. It could be used somewhere else potentially, but that's my specific knowledge of it. All right, dudes. So let me know in the comments some of the next one of these I should be listening to, and I will get to it as soon as I possibly can. And listen, dudes, you guys all have an amazing day. Have a super rebellious day. And so we have 10 seconds left. Let's see if we miss anything. All right, dudes, enjoy the rest of your day, okay?